Good evening. Let me introduce you to the characters of Pandora's box. Pradyuman Chandok as Zeus, voiceover Aditya Jain. Kush Jain as Vulcan, voiceover Prakar Singh Chauhan. Comedy Behani as Pandora, voiceover Nandini Bachawat. Chahat Panjwani as Anna, voiceover Navya Jain. Shriya Agrawal as Venus, voiceover Aditi Mehta. Manvi Chaju as Athena, voiceover Aditi Maheshwari. Aditya Kataria as Aphrodite, voiceover Ashray Maheshwari. Hia Edhasani as Diana, voiceover Nandini Pursnani. Parth Saklecha as Apollo, voiceover Dev Shah. Raghav Rati as Hermes, voiceover Atharv Shukla. Kushagra Dixit as Messenger God, voiceover Nimit Jain. Dehra Ajmera as Epimetheus, voiceover Aditya Kataria. Bhavya Sumrani as Prometheus, voiceover Savio Bastain. And the narrators are Nandini Sareen, Prasok Jain, Vidhi Patni, Prakhar Jain, Bhavya Saklecha, Ashi Vaidya, Aditya Ajmera, Parth Saklecha, Vandit Barjatya, Suryan Jain, and I, Nakul Bachawat. And the guards are Aditya Khandelwal and Parth Jain. Thank you.
One day, the almighty Zeus, upset with the brothers Prometheus and Epimetheus for bringing fire to humankind, decided to punish mankind because they were mean, evil, and arrogant. So he called his son Vulcan.
My dear son Vulcan, I want you to create a woman.
A woman? Why, father?
Don't dare question my decisions. It's an order, Vulcan.
But father, creating a woman is harder than making armor for Mars or a carved statue for Anna.
Don't give me the details. Just do it.
Very well. I'll start right away.
So Vulcan starts making a woman. And with his strong arms, he makes a woman as beautiful as the goddess. One day, Anna comes to see her.
She is very beautiful, Vulcan. You did a wonderful job. I will give her a belt full of pearls and a purple dress with precious stones.
The sweet Venus also comes to see her.
Anna was right. I truly admire your work. I will give her a gift of generosity, charity, and patience.
Then Aphrodite and Athena come together to see her.
We needed to see her, Vulcan. I also wanted to give her a gift. I gave her wisdom.
She's already beautiful, so I will give her only the gift of love.
And all the other gods and goddesses come to see her and gave her many gifts.
I gave her jewelry, flowers, and a little bit of curiosity. I gave her music.
And I gave you persuasion. After all the gods and goddesses had seen her and given her their gifts, Vulcan decides that it is time to take her to his father, Zeus.
Father, she is the woman you asked me to create.
She's perfect, and I can see that all the gods and goddesses have already given her gifts.
Yes, they have.
Very well. Then now it's my turn. Your name will be Pandora, which means the all gifted. But I also give you this box. which you should take it with you when you go down to earth.
It's a strange but beautiful box, Zeus.
It's more than that, Pandora. It's a very special box. This box is extremely beautiful on the outside. It's made of pure gold and covered with diamonds and rubies.
And it's so heavy. What does it have inside?
I can see that Diana gave you curiosity, Pandora.
Just a little.
Listen to me, Pandora. You should never ever open this box.
I won't, Zeus. I promise. I appreciate your gift. It's so beautiful and shiny that I can't stop looking at it.
Now, it's time for you to go down to Earth. Pandora, when you get to Earth, you will marry Epimetheus, Prometheus' brother. Vulcan, tell the messenger god to come. Pandora is ready to leave.
Yes, father.
Very well, Zeus. You are my creator and I will always obey you.
Meanwhile, Epimetheus and Prometheus are talking about Zeus.
Zeus must be very angry with me.
I know. You promised not to shield the fire, but you did.
Mortals needed it. Fire is useful for them.
Yes, but now we must be very careful.
Zeus is very clever. I know that by now he must be thinking of something. He will not forgive us. So please, brother, I warn you not to accept anything from him.
Don't worry, brother. I won't.
You have to promise me that you will not accept anything, even if it's a gift sent in friendship.
I told you not to worry.
Meanwhile, Epimetheus and Prometheus were talking about Zeus. A few days later, messenger god arrives at Epimetheus' house with Pandora.
What are you doing here?
Zeus sent me with this beautiful girl. She's a gift for you.
I don't understand. I know that Zeus is not happy for what my brother and I did.
Zeus has forgiven you. That's why she is here.
She's irresistibly beautiful. I accept her into my house. Please tell Zeus thank you.
I will. And her name is Pandora. Take good care of her.
Before you leave, tell me, what is that box she is holding in her hand?
It's a gift Zeus gave her before coming to Earth. She knows that she must not think of opening it.
But why? What's inside?
I cannot answer that question. But just remind her to keep her promise.
I will.
This is where we'll live from now on. Goodbye, Pandora.
You have a nice house. Earth is a strange place, but interesting.
Give me the box. I'll keep in a safe place.
Everything was perfect for a few days. But Pandora didn't have many things to do on Earth, and she was fed up. Besides, one of the goddesses had also given her curiosity.
I wonder what's inside the box. Maybe nothing will happen if I open it just a little. I could take a quick look and then close it. No, I better not. I made a promise. This is hard for me. I have to open it now.
So she lifts the lid from the box and she is horrified by what she sees.
Oh no, this is terrible.
The shadows of sickness, suffering, hatred, jealousy, greed, and violence starts to fill the happy houses of mankind.
What have I done? I have to close the box quickly.
She quickly closes the box. The spirit of hope remains inside the box. In spite of all the suffering, sickness, hatred, jealousy, greed, and violence that fill the happy homes of mankind, the spirit of hope remains to comfort man in distress. Thank you.